Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss about GPIO port of LPC-1767. Learning outcomes are, after completing this session, student will be able to summarize the GPIO port in LPC-1767 and compare the peripheral functions and number of pins in the various ports of LPC-1767. Let's have a look at overview of GPIO port in LPC-1767. The microcontroller LPC-1767 is having total 5 digital GPIO ports, port 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Port 0 and 2 can be used for wake up interrupt from reduced power mode. You know there are 4 power modes. First one is sleep, deep sleep, power down and deep power down. So port 0 and 2 is used for wake up interrupt. There are interrupts are enabled in the NVIC, that is nested vector interrupt controller. GPIO register are located on peripheral AHB bus for IO timing. Means I have told you in the architecture part, the GPIO port is directly connected with the multi-layer AHB matrix, that is advanced high performance bus. So that will improve its timing. GPIO register are accessible by GPDMA, that is general purpose direct memory access controller, to allow direct memory access of data to or from GPIO. All input output default to input, that is all GPIO are default to inputs with pull up register. The applications are normal general purpose input output, that is the biggest, driving LED or other indicators, controlling off chip devices. Hence, if you are interfacing any devices through GPIO, so you can control that. Next is sensing digital input, detecting edges. Last is bringing the part of power down mode. So this is also, this is the best. Let's have a look at the GPIO ports one by one. We'll start from port 0. So port 0 is a 32 bit input output port with individual direction control for each pin. So port 0 is what? 32 bit input output port. 28 pins can be used as a GPIO. These are typically shared with the other peripheral functions. So this is important. So port 0 are typically shared with the other peripheral functions like SSP, USB, CAN. And from the port 0, port 12, 13 and 14 are not available. Now let's have a look at the port 1. Port 1 is a 32 bit IO port with individual direction control for each bit. Again, 20 pins can be used as a GPIO. Again, that is typically shared with the peripheral functions like motor control PWM, quadrature encoder interface and Ethernet. Again, from port 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 11, 12, 13 are not available. Let's have a look at the port 2. Again, port 2 is a 32 bit IO port. 11 pins can be used as a GPIO. Now again, the shared with the peripheral functions like UART, motor control PDM and CAN. And from the port 2, 11 pin, 12 and 13 are not available. Let's have a look at the port 3. In port 3, only 23 and 26 are allowed, but these are not available. Now let's have a look at the port 4. So port 4 again it is 32 bit IO port. Only two pins can be used as a GPIO. Again, this is shared with the peripheral functions like UART or match output for timer 2. If you calculate the total GPIO pins, so there are maximum 70 GPIO pins are available on LPC1768 microcontroller. So this is about all the GPIO ports, and every port is having peripheral functions like UART, CAN or SSP. So we have discussed points related to various GPIO ports of LPC1768, that is port 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we have also discussed the peripheral functions and number of pins of various ports. So let's have a look at the next video.